Everyone, it's Christian here, and I am back with another palm review. And if you can hear me over the fans and the misters here in the greenhouse, this is a, well, it's not a single species. It's actually a nice hybrid. It is Dypsis leptochelios crossed with Dypsis decaryi. So that would be a triangle teddybear, teddybear triangle hybrid. And it's known as the red triangle or the tri-bear. I just call it the teddy bear triangle hybrid, but any of those names are fine. It's not a scientific, really that scientific. It's just a hybrid that's done between the teddy bear and the triangle. And it's actually very nice. If you look at the base here, or the it hasn't a clear chunk yet, but it has a very triangle-like look. Now the triangles are tristicious, meaning they have leaves that grow in three directions. One, two, and then back behind is three, and it keeps most of that characteristic of that triangle. Now, triangles also have a darker base like this. When younger, it's more of a purplish red, and this one's more of a maroon red, so it gets a little bit lighter when you get up here. And but this one, because of it, you can tell the maroon color, the white, this white here is very indicative of the hybrid, as that's a lot of what leptochelios has in it, naturally in its trunk. So the leaves are very much like a triangle. There's just a lot of tomentum here on the petiole or the rachis. Nice fuzziness, doesn't really wipe off. And in general, it looks a lot like a triangle. It just has a teddy bear base. And when they get older, they actually kind of hold this look. The trunk is actually relatively large, like a triangle, but it does still have the red characteristic about it and the tomentum and the fuzziness. It doesn't have as much fuzz as a regular teddy bear does, but there's a decent amount going on here. So these are becoming much easier to find. Maybe 10 years ago, they're quite sought after and valuable. A plant this size would probably go for $500. Now you can probably get this plant for about $150. And there's some also upsides to growing this palm. If you can't grow a teddy bear or a triangle where you live, but you're real close, say you live north of Tampa, maybe colder area of Orlando, maybe inland California or South France, parts of Spain, and you want to try and grow one, this one is actually more cold hardy than either one of them, and that's part of the hybrid vigor that comes with a lot of hybridized palms. So where the triangle, the teddy bear will probably be okay down to about 30 or 29, and a triangle's good down to about 26, 27. This one's probably good to about 23, 24. So that extra couple of degrees really helps you out. Great, because that'll help out. You'll be able to probably grow it. The other thing is it does grow faster than either one of them. Triangles are notorious, not notorious, but they're fairly slow considering. They're relatively easy to grow, just a little bit on the slower side for palms. And the teddy bear is about a moderate grower, like a 5 out of 10. A triangle is probably around a 4 out of 10. So this one's probably closer to a 7 or 8 out of 10 because of its hybrid vigor. It actually puts out a lot of leaves. Every leaf is a lot bigger than not a lot bigger, but they get much bigger as you go up here. You can see these, just on this crown alone, this leaf is about 4 feet long, and this one's about 5. This one here is about 6, and that one's about 8, and that one is about 10. So, and these have probably all been had in the past. This is probably the growth since the beginning of the year. So, it is relatively fast growing. Now, this palm is a mule, meaning that it will not put out seed, but just by itself, it needs a pollinator. So if you want to back cross it with, say, teddy bear again or a triangle again to give it more fuzziness or more of a triangle look, you're going to have to do it by hand because it will not put out seed by itself. So now the seed of this palm is going to look, it usually comes off of a triangle, and the seed is going to look identical to a triangle seed and germinate pretty much the same. And if you germinate, say, 1,000 seed that was grown where teddy bears and triangles are grown together, you might get two or three there. Sorry about the shakiness of the camera. I'm using one hand to talk. Well, I don't really need a hand to talk, but I'm only holding the camera with one hand here. So it takes a little bit more water in the crown than a triangle would normally want to, so it does handle the overhead watering much better. So that's about it. It will grow, like I said, similar to a triangle. Triangles don't like a ton of water. They like good drainage when they're younger. This one will take pretty much anything. It'll handle the more humid conditions that we have here in Florida. And so that's about it for this hybrid. It's definitely a good, if you can find one for a decent price, I would definitely say to go out and get it. I'd say you can get 1 gallon for probably $30 these days. So if you can find it, go and get one. Plant it in full sun, plant it in full shade, give it plenty of water, and it'll be a fast grower for you. So hope you enjoy this vlog. If you did, hit the like button. If you have any questions about this hybrid or some other hybrids, leave a comment down below. And if you're new to the channel and want to see more videos like this, go ahead and subscribe. And I will see you guys next time.